Right. What we learned yesterday? We learned about these are the points. Number one, what is data? From where we are getting this data, we understood. Then we went for how many types of data available, we understand. These are two types of data. One is transactional, second is analytical data. Then how many types of databases available, we understood. These are also two types of data. One is OLTP data, then OLAP data. Then data warehousing architecture, we are going to discuss this one. Now Informatica role in the data warehousing also, we are going to discuss these two points, we are going to discuss today. Okay, next, RIT training standards we discussed already yesterday. So as part of this one, what are the things I am going to provide? It may be materials or services, whatever it is. Now today let us go and try to understand one thing that is called as data warehousing architecture. This is what called as data warehousing architecture. Before going for this class, do you have any questions regarding yesterday class? Krishna, Santosh, Sri Govind? No, right? Okay, that's good. Let us go and try to understand today's class then. Data warehousing architecture. As part of this architecture, first let us say any big organization you are taking, any one big business you are taking, we need here surely one guy. That guy is known as customer. Without customers, there is no business. Without customers, there is no business. At the same time, to service these customers, we need here employees also required. Without employee also, there is no business. So in any business, customers are very important and also employees are very important. That is the reason outside the applications are available, only two types of applications are available. One is called as CRM applications. CRM application stands for what? CRM application stands for what? CRM. Customer. Relationship, then management. Customer relationship management. Okay, this is what the CRM. Now in the CRM, if you go and observe, do we have any softwares you are aware of it? One of the software we are aware of it is called as Sybil. Sybil is the one software which is going to take care of the CRM. Mainly in this one, I can say one is called as marketing, second is called as sales, third is called as service. So these are the three main modules. We have a number of modules are available. These three things are called as main modules. Main modules. Now similarly, we have here SAP guy also providing what? CRM. And similarly, we have here right now also one of the CRM. Similarly, we have here Salesforce is one of the CRM. And like this, we have so many CRMs are available. What these all guys are doing it? Let us say you purchased one, you developed one good product that is called as one mobile. You placed that one in the market, let us say in the retail store you kept, or in the online portal you kept, or in the Facebook or some social website you placed one ad, we placed it. One of the customers shown interest on that one. Whenever he shown interest on that one, on that product, first you are going to collect whatever the details are available from the customer, those all things. How you are collecting those details? Using some kind of beautiful form, right? In the form, the fields are available. What is the first name? What is the last name? What is the middle name? From where he is looking for? What he is looking for? When he is planning to buy? A number of details are available. So you are collecting what data. At the time of marketing, we are collecting data using one form. That form is developed using any one of the softwares. Now this marketing data, whatever available, that will go as the input to the sales. Let's say 20 members shown interest on the phone. The sales guy will be calling those guys you have the interest on this phone. Okay, you want to purchase today. Something is going to coordinate with that guy. You'll try to convert his marketing records into sales records. So out of, let us say, 20 records, two are converting into the sales also, it is good. And from the sales records, we are going for what? Service. So whenever we sell one product, that any problem is available, we are responsible to give the warranty or guarantee, whatever applicable to the product. Now, overall, what I am trying to say is, here we have some applications. These applications are useful to collect the data from the customer. Okay, we collected the data, that is fine. And only from employees only we are going to collect the data. Marketing sales service means, okay, it is customers. Now, employees also we are going to collect the data or not? That's where we have here ERP. ERP means enterprise relationship. Enterprise relationship management here. Okay. If you go and try to observe planning, enterprise resource planning. Now we have here number one, first point. Under the enterprise resource planning, what are the things we are going to cover? Or who are the vendors are available to support this ERP? We have one of the vendor, that vendor is known as EBS. That is nothing but Oracle Labs, EBS. This also people used to call it as Oracle Apps, or people used to call it as Oracle, Artur, blah blah, whatever you call it as, say. E-business suit. Now number two is available. Let us say we have one thing that guy is called as PeopleSoft. Number three is available, that is called as JD Edwards. Number four is available, that is called as, let us say, SAP ERP. SAP CRM is available. SAP ERP is available. In fact, Sybil also ERP is available, but it is not famous. Any product you are taking, those guys are trying to provide CRM as well as ERP. But one thing will be famous in one area. So if you take here EBS, even though it's saying as I'm going to support the HR data and all, but it is known for or famous for what type of data? Finance data. Even though PeopleSoft guy is saying as I am going to do everything, but it is famous for HR data. JD Edwards is famous for manufacturing unit, manufacturing data. SAP ERP, its own packages are available. Okay. Anyhow, as of now, what I am trying to say is we have here two applications. One is called as CRM application, ERP application. Now in my prospective, I am saying as CRM and ERP are applications. ERP are applications. In these applications, we are trying to type some data. Let us say I want one laptop. I want 4 GB of the RAM, 500 GB of the hard disk, and so processor, i5 processor or i7 processor, something, and I selected all the options. The moment I clicked on the submit, immediately what will happen is, we are going to get the data from application to where? OLTP. From application to OLTP, we are going to get the data. Once we got the data into the OLTP, what next? We are trying to extract the data, and we are trying to transform the data, and we are trying to load the data. Okay, first we have the data into the OLTP, that is, we are happy. Only one OLTP will be available, or n number of OLTPs will be there. For example, if I take one banking things, they have accounts management. saving account, corporate account, current account, okay, fixed deposit account, like the number of accounts are there. And they too have loans management. Okay, loans like personal loan, home loan, these all things. Are they tracking these all things using the same customer number or different customer numbers they are collecting? Different customer numbers, right? Different customer numbers. So that means backend tables, if you go and observe, same table we are storing the loan data and accounts data, or different tables are going to maintain? Accounts data as well as loans data, both they're going to maintain the single table or different tables? Single table you are going to maintain. If you maintain single table, then the columns whatever which is required for the saving account, the columns which are required for the loan account, is it both are same? You mean to say in case of saving account, we are going to collect some kind of parameters. Same parameters are going to collect from the loan account also? No. The way it operates also different. So what I'm trying to say is the columns whatever we required for loan account, the columns whatever you required for saving account, these all things, it is different. And how it is going to operate also, it is different. The reason, mostly what we are going to do is we are going to maintain different tables. The moment we are saying as different tables, it automatically becomes what? Different OLTPs. Different OLTPs. These are all different tables. We are going to one kind of tables we are going to place in one table. Sorry, one database. One kind of tables we are going to place in another database. If I take one more best example, let's say Google. Google has YouTube, one application. And Google has Google search engine, and Google has Gmail. N number of applications are available. Each application, whatever it is showing in the front end, the options different. So ideally, to support that application back end, whatever tables they are storing, whatever format is available, the type of the database, the speed of the database will be changes from application to application or not. Yes. If you are going for the YouTube, then video supporting streaming is fast. I want that kind of database. If you go for the Gmail, something streaming is not required because there is no video files kind of thing over there. So overall, what I want to say is, based on the application, we are deciding the OLTP. Based on the application, we are deciding the OLTP. Under one organization, you may have n number of OLTPs. Under one organization, you may have n number of OLTPs. Okay, that point is very clear. Let us say we are trying to store that some data here, we are trying to store some data here. Even though in the diagram I given ERP total data, we are storing one OLTP, it may be different also. Different ERPs may be available under the same environment, but ideally one only there. Ideally one only they have to maintain. If you maintain like they maintain like that, then it will be very CRM corresponding one, ERP corresponding one, they have to maintain. Now inside this one, whatever data available, what this data is called as transactional data. Transactional data. Now, customer whatever placed one order, he placed. Let's say order one he placed. For the Dell laptop he placed. Okay, next order two he placed. You want, let us say, one mobile, you want it. Like this, a number of orders the players came on storing here. Now, it's a company of some retail company. Let us say Amazon.com is the company. End of the year, Amazon need to understand what are the products which are sold more. I want to know top 10 products. Which are the products which are sold less? That kind of reporting I want. So end of the day, we have to get this all orders data, whatever the information we needed, that information we have to extract or not. We have to extract it. Here, let us say in a table, you may have here 100 columns you may have here. but 100 columns may not be required for further processing purpose. Whatever columns you needed for further processing purpose, only those things are going to extract here. For example, see this one once. Let us say I am trying to open one live example only. We'll see and we'll try to understand this architecture. We'll see one live example and we'll try to understand this live architecture. Let us say, I hope everyone aware of the employee dimension, right? That's what I want to take employee corresponding mapping. Let us go for EBS. Ora R12 means it's a EBS. E business suit. Now I am going for the mappings. Now what is the mappings available here? Employee dimension. What table you are loading here? W_employee_DS table you are loading it. Data is coming from where? Coming from here. Inside this one also we have again some kind of mapping is available. If you want to see that one, right click, open this object. This object is called as maplet. What is maplet? We'll discuss later. As of now, let me open that. If you open, now tell me what this table is called as. Here I have one table. The table is called as per_all_assignments_f table is available. So now we are talking about OLTP tables. This OLTP tables, whatever available. OLTP tables whatever available. Number one is called as per_all_assignments_f. This is a table. What type of table it is? From OLTP it is coming. That is the reason we used to call this as what? Source table. Now from this assignments table, are you taking all the columns to the next level or whatever columns you want, only those columns are taking? Are you taking assignment ID next level? Is this blue arrow mark is available? Blue arrow mark is available or not available? Not available. So blue arrow mark is not available. Is assignment ID, you are not taking it. Recruiter ID, you are not taking it. Then we are not taking your payroll ID, you are not taking. Whatever you taking, you want it, just go and try to observe here. So location ID you are taking, then we are trying to take here business group, we are trying to take it, business group ID, then position ID, and whatever you want, only those things you are taking, right? So if I go and if I try to say from this table, what are the columns you are taking? Business_group_ID, that's the one column what you are taking here. Second, what you are taking? Position underscore ID. That is the one column we are taking. And next, what you are taking here, if you go and try to see it, this one. What is this? Location underscore ID. This is called as what actually? Column, right? This is called as column. Only whatever you needed, only those columns we are taking it, not all the columns. Whatever you needed exactly, only those columns we are taking from this table. Only one source table is available or n number of sources are available. This is the one source. What is for next one? This is one more table is available. Per_all_people_f. Previous one is what? Assignments table. This is people table. This is one more source table. Luckily, in my case, actually, both are coming from same database. But there is no rule like it has to come from same database. Yeah, same OLTP database. It may be coming from different things also. For example, let me show you one small thing so that you can come to understand. I am trying to take here B225 RRI tech rep then they have here some mapping. Right, here we have the giant types understanding is available. Giant types understanding is available. Tell me now, if I right click here, then it is coming from where? It's coming from where? Oracle. Oracle database. This is coming from where? Flat file, there is Notepad. Both are same or different? Different. That means, can I say now, this is one OLTP 1, this is one OLTP 2. The data sources data may be coming from same database or may not be coming from same database. Okay, that's fine. In, let us go for our continuation of the example. Yeah, heterogeneous. The word is heterogeneous word is suitable for here. Previous one, whatever example I was talking about, right? This is now homogeneous only. Why? Because both are coming from this table as well as this table. Both are coming from Oracle database only. So both are homogeneous. Both are homogeneous. Now, if you go and try to take here people underscore F table, what is the column is available here? Person underscore ID is the column available. Only that column we are taking here. So we are taking a column that is called as person underscore ID column. We are taking it. This is a one column. Next we are taking here, that is called as effective start date. We are taking it. Effective start date. We are taking it. Effective start date. We are taking it. This is the one column. So on. Click on extra. It is so on. App taking from here. Here also, it will be taking the so on. Only three columns only I written here wantedly. You may have four, five columns also may be available. Now, is it second table, only second table, two tables are available or in, n number of things are there? One more is what? HR lookups. In HR lookups, we are trying to take here, meaning we are taking. Okay, remaining all things are, it's okay. Then this is what called as HR lookups. The HR lookups is the one more source table. HR lookups is the one more source table. Under that one, we are trying to take here one column. What is the column we are taking? Meaning is the column we are taking it. We are taking column called as meaning is the column we are taking it. Meaning is the column we are taking it. Now overall, that's fine. Let us go for next one. I'm going for here HR lookups. Next is what? RA underscore sales rep underscore all. If you go and try to take care RA underscore sales rep underscore all, there is a one more table. And inside that one, we have some columns. Out of these columns, which one you are using as a output, we have to observe. We have here one thing that's called as what? Last updated date. Now, similarly, if you go down, here we have one thing that's called as last column. What is this one? Commissionable flag is available. Okay, for the sales representative, what we are trying to get here, that is available. So this is called as what now? Source table. Overall, what I want to say is the data is coming from only one table of the source or a number of tables of the source. A number of tables. This a number of tables need to be in same database or it may be different databases. It may be different database also. That's what I want you to understand. That means we are not extracting all the columns whatever available here. We are extracting only whatever we needed for the business analysis purpose. Only those columns we are taking. Whatever we needed for business analysis purpose, only those columns we are trying to extract it. So only business analysis required data extracting. We are not extracting all the things, we are not extracting only whatever things are required for the business analysis. Only that data only we are trying to extract it. Okay, once you extract, extracting is nothing but pulling the data. We are pulling the data by writing here some kind of SQL query. We are going to write here one SQL query, we are going to write it, and we are going to do that one. Okay, this SQL query maybe looks like you're very big. Don't worry about that one. Even though it appears big, it is very simple. Okay, you come to understand once I start explaining this one. Right? As of now, we are extracting whatever data you want. Only that data we are trying to extract it. Now, let us say we extracted your data. That's fine. What next we are doing it? One moment. Now we have here. We taken whatever columns we required. Next, what we are doing here? We are trying to get the related data by using some lookup. And we are also doing some kind of calculations also we are doing here, right? If you go and see here, we are trying to apply here some kind of calculations. So if you see here, what is this one? Two char, can I call it as one calculation? Converting data type is one calculation or not? One calculation. And we have here also two char is available. And here also two char is available. Whatever you needed, we are trying to calculate here. We are trying to convert one form of data into another form. Once you converted one form of data into another form, what we are doing end of the day? We are loading into one table. What is the table here? W underscore. Employee underscore DS table. What is this table? From where we are loading? OLTP to staging area. Did you observe the table naming convention here? At the last we have here S. S stands for here staging area. Actually in the data warehouse, first, let me write here. We are trying to load data where to where? Staging area, we are loading the data. The staging area table is this one, the staging area table. Okay, now while you are loading this data into the staging area table, we are trying to extract whatever we needed, and also we are converting one form of data into another form. We are converting one form of data into another form. You can change data types, you can change the calculations also, you can do it. Here in this example, data type change is there. It doesn't mean that always data type change only. Let us say, I have some examples. Let me show you what you mean by transformation. I will show some examples so that you will be able to understand it. See this one. What is this here? What I am doing? Here in the source, I have last name, first name. What I am trying to do? I am trying to concatenate. This is called as transformation. It doesn't mean that one converting the data types only transformation. Any type of calculation is called as transformation. Simply one form of data we are trying to change as the other form of data. If you see this example, next one. I have here orders arrive every 2 minutes. What I am trying to calculate? Aggregation. What is available here? daily productivity figures. What we are trying to take? Average. Today I am able to walk, or I am able to develop, let us say, two programs. Tomorrow I develop three programs. Day after tomorrow I develop four programs. What is my average productivity means? 2 plus 3 plus 4 by 3 we are going to do it, right? That is average. Here I have the data type conversion. Age string is available. I am converting into integer. Here date is available like that. We are splitting into in this format. And money is available, rupees. We are converting into dollars. We have here pounds. We are converting into kilograms. We have here is, we are trying to split 20 to 25 age group people. How many members are there? One member. 26 to 30 age group of people. How many people are there? Four. These all things are called as conversions only, transformations only. Here, from the source one, from table one, I mean to say, we are getting the gender as male and female. Here we are getting the male and female. Here we are getting the one and two. Now overall, these all things we are trying to convert into single format. M and F only we are converting. Okay, like that we are going to convert one form of data into another form. The process of converting one form of data into another form is called as what? Transformation. Okay, in our case, we are converting one form of data into another form. In our case, it is just data type we changed it. Only data type we changed it. Now we have here next one, W underscore employee underscore DS. Whatever data available here, this total data we stored here. This table is called as, D stands for dimension, S stands for staging. Actually, tables in our thing is only two types of tables are available in the data warehouse. I am going to talk much about those things later. What is the table? Dimension. Best dimension table is called as, let us say we have product, and next service, geography, time. These are the tables. And what are the meaning of fact table here? This is what the fact table. Only two types of tables are available in our case. One is dimension table. Second is fact table. Here dimension table, D stands for dimension table. S stands for dimension staging table. Dimension staging table. That means from these all source tables, we are trying to load the data into where? Staging table. Now, as of now, the data came from where to where? OLTP to staging area. What is the area this is called as? Staging area. This one nothing but whatever I said now in our example, staging area is nothing but what now? W underscore, employee underscore, DS is the staging area table. From this one, we have to load what? Data warehouse, you have to load it. Data warehouse purpose, what is available then? Data warehouse purpose, what is available then? If you go and try to see your other mapping, let us say I am trying to disconnect here. Then we are going for other mapping here. Other mapping here. We can observe. I have here one thing that is called as employee dimension will be available. Already is open. Okay. Just guess it. If you see by seeing this diagram, guess it. What is the source for this loading? Staging table, right? That means whatever we have here, this table is going as a input. Previously it was target. In previous mapping, it is what? Target. Now in this mapping, it is source. Now if you go and observe carefully here, I have a table, what is the table? W underscore employee underscore DS. This table now acting as what? Source in this case. Previous case it was target. And blah blah we are doing internally. I mean to say, we are doing some kind of integration rules we are applying. Finally, we are loading the data. Finally, we are loading the data into which table? This was the table. Is it what it is? Target W underscore employee underscore D. What is W underscore employee underscore D? Dimension table stores personal information about employees belongings to the this organization as well as its extended organization. Previous organization data also is going to store it. The concept of the extended organization would take care of contractors, third-party organizations, and other non-employees who help us to run our business. It doesn't mean that one only, if suppose this training center you take it, I am required, and even some third-party people, like we are getting one book, we are getting, right? How we are getting that book? I am not taking the Xerox. Someone has to do for that, right? That is what we are calling it as here, supporting. Our business, those guys are supporting it. Those things also we are trying to store in our employee table. That's what the meaning of here, extended organizations data also we are trying to store it. Okay, blah, blah, we are doing here. Finally, we are trying to load this data into our data warehouse. We are trying to load our data. So overall, what I want to say is, the data we are loading into data warehouse. In the data warehouse, what is the table name? In the data warehouse, what is the table name? The table name is this, what is the table name? D. This is the final our data warehouse table. Now you tell me, you understand what is the meaning of extracting, transforming, and loading? Doing these three activities only done by our Informatica tool. Today I know that here I am opening some windows, it may be a bit confusing. The words itself may be confusing, I know that. But still, I want to relate the architecture with your work. Now I think you are able to relate it, right? What do you mean by OLTP? OLTP is nothing but set of tables. These set of tables are coming from same database or different databases. You know, I think employee dimension is very simple dimension. You are going to assign to some project, yes or no? That information is available in one table. You are going to belong to something called as some people information, what you are. And we have here, who is your HR, like that. So this all information we are loading first into the DS table. From there, we are trying to load into the final data warehouse table. We are trying to load it. Final data warehouse table, we are trying to load it. Okay, excellent. Now we understand extracting, transforming, and loading. ETL means nothing but end of the day, functionally if I define. Whatever I define till this point of time, it's technical. Functionally if I define, converting this transactional data, whatever available in the OLTP. In OLTP, what is the data available? Transactional data. The transactional data we are giving as input to the ETL, from here it produces what? Analytical data it produces, it's going to load into the data warehouse. Now can I say, ETL is a process to convert transactional data into analytical data. ETL is a process to convert transactional data into analytical data. That's what we can define the ETL. Please write this point. ETL is a process to convert transactional data into analytical data. Okay, once you convert it into the analytical data, what is the next agenda? People, reporting people will be coming into the picture. They will be developing the semantic layer, reports and dashboards. This is not our business. We need not learn about what exactly meaning of semantic layer, what exactly meaning of report dashboards. Even strictly speaking, this also we are least bother. We are bother about only the things, this is what is required. Being a ETL resource, you need to understand what is our source, what is staging area, what is target, how to extract the data, how to transform the data, how to load the data. That's what we have to understand. Okay, what will happens in the process of the this one? If you see a data averaging tools, we have here two process, right? One is ETL process, second is reporting process. The reason tools also divide into two types. One is ETL tools, second is reporting tools. ETL side we have the Informatica, Data Stage, Ab initio, SSIS, ODA, OWP, BODA, even a number of things are available. Even I too don't know so many things. Around 100 plus tools are available. 100 plus tools are available. What we are aware of it, whatever we are seeing in our projects, we are aware of it. The mainly used tools are, these are the tools which are available in the market. Reporting side also, so many tools are available, but the mainly used tools are, these are the mainly used tools. Any questions on this slide? Yeah, we will not bother about the reporting. Now, yesterday I explained about RRI Tech training outline. What exactly I am going to cover? Data Analytics concepts, Informatica 9.6. We divide as a learner level, specialist level, chapter wise PPTs, chapter wise basic level hands-ons, chapter wise project level hands-ons, chapter wise recordings we are going to deliver, and specialist level same way it is organized in Pharma Live project. External tools, OBA free built of work of Informatica. See here, whatever I shown here, right? This is not developed by me. It's developed by Oracle guy directly, Oracle. And it is a plug and play concept. Actually, it is called as OBA. There is a one more product is available, OBA. That we can plug and we can move the data, everything. That kind of concept we developed it. Okay, anyhow, so what I'm trying to say is that kind of pre-built work you are able to understand. This is a code really using real time. This one you are able to understand it, then you are up to mark or not. Your training standards are industry standards or not. That's what we are going to train you at the end of this one. All best practices are going to learn from OBA. Right, I'll show next one is ODA basic level. Training. Even ODA is also one of the same tool, ETL tool, but we used to call it as ELT tool. Extracting first, loading second, transformation third. That's what ODA is going to do it. That extracting, loading, transformation. General Informatica is what is doing extracting, transformation, loading. Okay, that also we are going to give the free of training. Basic level of training is free. Now that point is very clear for us. This OLTP versus OLAP, I will talk later. Now, what are the tables are available? We will discuss this. It is a small piece of chapter. We have two tables are available. One is called as fact table. Second is dimension table. What do you mean by fact here? If you go and see here, this diagram. Any of this kind of columns we are seeing. What is sales revenue, net profit, gross margin, cost, profitability, this kind of things you are seeing it. Then it is called as fact table. And always fact table will contain numbers and it can be summarized. If you want to apply the sum also, you can go and you can apply it. Tell me, these facts are useful as a key performance indicators, I said. What is the meaning of one? I given here, facts are measures. Are the key performance indicators of an enterprise. If I given my profitability number to you, you are able to justify or able to estimate how my organization is doing job or not. Yes. Suppose profitability is positive number, this guy is doing good. Profitability is negative number, this guy is not doing. Maybe that all the things like your business is not running means it doesn't mean that one the business owner only problematic guy. n number of parameters. Let us say you are selling one thing that is called as black and white mobile phones are selling. Black and white mobile phones you are selling. If I keep that one, no one will purchase it. Is it problem? Is owner problem? No. Product. Product is outdated product, I can say. Product is outdated product. So that means business is not running means it may not be problem always from the owner side. It may be problem from the product side. It may be problem from the people side. People may not be economically not strong. Then also we cannot sell the things. Suppose we have here in India, let us say US you take and India you take. Our resource only, India resource, we went over there means immediately we'll buy the SVU car. Correct or not? But here we want to purchase that. We'll be going for the small cars only, we'll go for it. What is the difference here? Cost. And there we are getting the cheap cost, here we are not getting that cost, right? So product is same. But based on the location, the which car is selling more is changing here. So business will be changes based on n number of parameters. Maybe owner, it may be location, it may be product, it may be time also matters. Time also matters, everything is matters. So overall, all the parameters you take care, I will give the profitability number. If the profitability number is positive or negative, based on that one, you're able to justify my business is doing or good or bad. All these parameters are like this parameters only. Using these parameters, if you develop the table, using these parameters, if you develop the table, then this table is called as what? Fact table. Unit sold and revenue. This is a measures. Okay, measures. That's what is called as fact table. I'll talk this one more in tomorrow's class. Today, what your understanding is, only this one is your understanding, right? Only this one is our understanding. I am giving the chart. Please try to keep somewhere. I will give very less notes. I will give, sir. If whenever I am giving that less notes, please try to make somewhere documentation. Am I clear? Any questions you have? Any questions you have? If no, tomorrow we'll try to meet. And tomorrow, what is my expectation from you is, whatever we have here, Informatica lab copy, right? Please try to download this Informatica lab copy into your local machine, which you need to download from the Google Drive. The URL, the permissions, everything will be given by the HR. Please touch base with the HR. That is the number one, what I am expecting from you. Download this total, whatever available, this one you have to download it. This one you have to download it. Number two, what I am expecting is software installation. Try to install the softwares in our machines. Or at least get the software first. What do you have to do? Get the softwares and ready with that. I am going to explain the installation process. Once I explain the installation process, then we have to install it. First, ready the get the softwares. Sorry? Yeah, yourself, you are going to install the Informatica. I am going to give that lecture. I am going to give it. As part of that lecture, I will deliver how to install it. If you go and see here, Informatica, classroom notes. There, I given the screenshot wise. I given the installation steps. I am also walk through the steps. Here, I given the Informatica installation. Server installation and client installation, I given the step by step I given. As we given the step by step, we are able to install our own, don't worry. Server as well as client. But first get the softwares and ready with your things. Yeah, you can get the softwares from the admin. Kiran is available here. From that you are getting. Your materials you have to get from the HR. Either Renuka or one more girl is available, Soumya. Okay, these are the two girls are available. Those guys are going to help you out. Evening time we are coming means Purna is going to help you out. Admin is Kiran is available. Those four members are going to help you out with respect to the materials as well as with respect to the installations. You have to touch base with them. Any technical things are available, you can approach me. Okay. Thank you. Tomorrow we'll meet same time. Bye bye.